to the realm of faith. Sometimes we fail, we get in a realm of our own, and we forget about who God really is. You see, by faith, the elders obtained a good report. Joshua and Caleb's report was a good report because it was a faith report. Sometimes our faith is not what it should be. Why was it, or of the other 10 spies that brought back what the Bible calls an evil report? Why was it an evil report? Because it was contrary to what the Word of God said that was going to happen. I feel like that I'm talking to someone today. You've been listening to an evil report. You see, anymore when the Bible says cancer, that doesn't mean death. When they say you got a disease that's uncurable, doesn't mean that it isn't uncurable. It simply means they can't do anything with it. But God can do all things. When the doctor said, there's nothing else I can do, that's when Jesus steps in and he takes care of it. When you go to job interview and he says, hey, we can't use you. I want to tell you, he can't maybe use you, but God's got a place for you. And the good news, and in all ways, the bad news, if we trust in the Almighty God. You've been listening. Somebody here today has been listening to an evil report. You've been listening to your circumstances. You've been listening to what your feelings are and saying what your enemies are saying, and the enemies are not your friend. If Isaiah asked the question, whose report are you going to believe? David was trending his father's flock one day, and a lion suddenly appeared and he stole one of the lambs that were there in that flock. You know, most people would have said, I'll never see that lamb again. Most people would have just written it off, and one of the lion's casualty, and said, the devil got one and there ain't nothing I can do about it. How many times have we let the devil get by with stealing something from us, and we've shook our head and said, there's nothing I can do. I can't do anything. But he can do all things if we'll let him do it. Yes. Most people would have said, I'd better stay here and protect what I've got. Yes. And that's what the devil wants us to do. I mean, the lion was counted off. The devil said, I mean, the lion was counted off. Nothing you can do about it. You can't do a thing. It's done got it in his mouth. David wasn't like most people. He took it personally, and the Bible said that he took it hard. He angered him that the lion would break into his fold and invade the privacy, invade the safety of his fold instead of it. No doubt the devil said, hey, I got that lion and there ain't nothing you can do about it. And many of us have said it. The devil's broke in and stole from us. He stole marriages and he stole up ministry, and he's killed some of our young people, and he's caused some of them to go places that they don't need to go, and he's still doing it today. He is trying to destroy, but that ain't what David said. No doubt this devil was carrying sons and daughters off into drugism and homosexualism and perversion, but when this was the first flock David had ever had to be invaded, it was not the first lamb that had ever been stolen out of front. After time, he left him a broken woman and man. The devil has left us a broken home, broken children, took everything we had, and we stood there helpless and don't know what to do. Well, I come by to tell you tonight, there's something you can do. You can put it in the hand of the Master, and everything gonna be all right. Amen. devil had succeeded once again. This church would have been full tonight, except the devil interfered with people coming to the house of God. He's put hindrances in the way. Instead of David sitting down and crying and saying like Chris Christopherson did, "Why me, Lord? What did I ever do? Poor old me, what did I ever do? Why did this have to happen to me?" David refused just to ride his losses and settle for leftovers like some of us do every day. Because the devil comes against us and we get mad, but we don't do anything about it. You can't do anything about it by yourself. It takes the power of God to do something about it. You can't just stand there with your hands out. My God is greater than any devil that's ever walked the face of this earth. He's greater than any devil that comes up and down and talks about the brethren to the Lord. He's greater than that. You have power. You have authority. You have faith. You have substance. You have pride. But I want to tell you, there's a man by the name of Jesus that's able to sustain you from all of your problems. Amen. Let me stop right here and tell you, some of you right here selling tonight for leftovers. I never did like leftovers. The only thing I like about leftovers is spaghetti. I don't know, there's something about spaghetti, Brother Melton, when it gets all them ingredients in it and it's set, it's better. But how many likes cold chicken? Boy, I don't. Cold taters. I don't. You like cold chicken, Brother Taylor? You like cold taters? You like anything cold left over? Ice cream. It better be ice cream or you'll be dipping it with a spoon. But instead of sitting down, feeling sorry for himself, like so many Sister Mott does today. Right. Poor old me. Yeah. Look what I'm going through. This may be the last valley you have to go through. This may be the last time the devil ever puts more on you than you can bear.
Yes.
Hold on. Hold on. Yes. Glory to God. Hold on. Amen. Somebody lift your hand and say, "Praise the Lord." Hold on. The God that we serve is not going to forsake us. He's not going to turn his back on us. He's not going to turn around on us. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You have a power. You have a being on the inside of you. Don't you bow your head down to the devil. You're somebody. You've been bought by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. You've been sanctified holy. You've been baptized with the Holy Ghost. There ain't no need of showering down to the enemy. Just have something. Be happy you got something left. Just thankful that the devil didn't take everything you have. Just thankful to still be in your right mind. Satisfying just to have enough money to make ends meet. Maybe you won't never be a millionaire. Maybe you won't ever have $1 billion. But praise God, if you got enough to pay your bills and go out to the steakhouse every now and then, you got something. You ought to throw your hands in the air and glorify the Lord. He never promised you everything, but he promised you supply your needs. Well, I just believe I'm talking to somebody that's sick and tired of having leftovers. I just believe somebody here want some of that milk. And honey, I just believe somebody here believe that God is going to bless them and help them. David could have done like most people and settled down with the leftovers. The lion didn't get but one of those little sheep. I don't know if you know anything about a sheep or not. But a sheep is an animal that will not fight for nothing. Sister Roseanne, y'all have had sheep. You know what I'm talking about. One of the most stubborn, bullheaded animals. They're more stubborn than humans. Some of them. And if something grabs that sheep, they don't fight. Do this, Sister Roseanne. They just lay down. And that animal can maul that sheep and kill it, Brother Charles. And he'll never do a thing about it but lay there and die. So when the lion grabbed the sheep, he took it by the throat and he left. David could have done like a lot of those people who settled down with leftovers, and he could have said, let that one go. But that great shepherd, he left the 99, and the Bible said he went out and he searched for it until he found it. David went after the lion and he hunted it down. And he found him. And the lamb was still in his mouth. Alive. The Bible said he spoke to him. And he took him out of the lion's mouth. Hallelujah. The lion rose up against him. And David caught him by the beard. And he killed him. He didn't play with him. He killed him.
Amen.
Every nature's evidence would have told David, write it off. It's just one little lamb. But the truth was that lamb had not been torn to shreds by the lion's paw or teeth. This lion was still alive. He was still alive. When you feel like the devil is raking and tearing at you and you can feel it, I want you to know, think about it. You're not dead because you can still feel the devil coming at you. You're not alive. And the power of God will deliver you if you'll only let it. The lion rose up against him. I got some good news for you. The good news that when the devil gives you bad news, it's going to be wrong. Because he is the father of a lie. Do you know the devil can't tell the truth? I know some people like that.
Amen.
Come on now, I'm telling you the truth. I know some people like that. They can't tell the truth. It ain't that they can't, they're just not going to. And all liars shall have their place in the lake of fire.
Yes.
We must understand that we're going through trials and we're going through troubles and we're going through tribulation. But there's one thing we need to understand. God will not allow the devil to tempt you beyond where you can't take it. Hold on. Hold on, folks. My God is still in the business. He's still alive and he's still performing miracles. said you're going to die. But the good news said, you shall live and not die.
Amen.
Thank the Lord for that. The bad news said, you're going to lose your mind. But the good news said, thou will keep him in perfect peace whose mind stayeth on thee. Glory. Hallelujah. So that tells me everybody in this building ought to understand that the devil can take your mind, but the Lord will let you know if you keep your mind upon him, he will touch you and help you and make you whole. So when you look at your husband and say, hey, you're crazy. Are you wise? Are you... Why a husband looks at you and says, you're crazy. You let them know that you're not crazy because you will keep in perfect peace because he stays on your mind at all times. The bad news said that Lamb is gone, that marriage is dead, that son or that daughter is a hopeless case. The bad news said you'll never see your dreams fulfilled. You'll never have that ministry that you embarked on. But the good news is the bad news is wrong. Hallelujah, because Jesus is still the Son of the living God, and he changes not, and he has the power to change you and make you new. The Lamb was not dead. I think that's the moral of this story. He didn't die. Even though the lion, the devil, grabbed him and chewed at his throat, he was still alive.
Amen.
I think the moral of this thing is to let you know, even though the devil can eat at you and tempt you and try you and throw you down and hold you down, the moral of this story is you're not going to stay down. You're not going to stay down because there's something called the resurrected power of the Lord Jesus Christ that will not let you stay down, but you're going to get up with the fire and the power of the Almighty God. The good news and the bad news is wrong. It may be bad right now, but it can get better if you'll trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh yeah. It was the lion's intention to kill the lamb. But God wouldn't let the enemy close his mouth. Now you know, if that lion had put his mouth down with all those teeth, Brother Milton, that lamb would have been gone. And the greatest thing I want to tell you tonight is that lamb was alive.
Amen.
Something held that lamb, that lion's mouth open. Something caused that lion not to grasp down on that lamb. Sister Mary, I know what that was. Oh, hallelujah. I said, I know what kept that lion from pressing down on that lamb. Sometimes you better understand God stopped that lion, and he can stop the devil anytime he gets ready. But sometimes he let you go through trials and tribulations and times of bad times to see if you're going to choice. Life is not fair. It's not. It's not fair that a man would work all of his life, and the end of his working, that he would die. Sister Roseanne, that's not fair. I would to God that he would give him some time, Brother Charles, to enjoy himself. You're retired. I say retired now. And you and Sister Maud are having some great fun. You've worked all these years trying to help people. Tell them that Jesus is alive and that he's coming. Now somebody's had to take the reins on. You know, a lot of people would say, where are they at? They're enjoying themselves. They fought the battle. It ain't over. They ain't dead yet. But I envy them with all my heart that they can go and do as they please. But I still got a burden for this church. And as long as that burden's there, I've got to warn you that the enemy is just like that lion. He is trying to destroy you. He's trying to destroy your family. He's trying to destroy your children. He'll destroy everything you got if you let him. The good news is that the bad news is wrong. The devil might have you. He may have his hook in you. But if you've been bought by the blood, hold on. Victory is on the way. With every head bowed and every eye closed, you know, one of the hardest things that I have ever done in all my ministry is for my wife to get sick and go home and I stay and preach. But I promise the Lord, if you'll take care of her, I'll preach your word. And I'm doing it. There's not a person in this building that I don't love with all my heart. But some of you are allowing the enemy to take your joy away. The devil's run off with some of your sheep, being your children, your grandchildren. And you feel so helpless. There's nothing I can do. But tonight, there is something you can do. Tonight, if you need something from God, or if you've got children that are lost and done undone without God, maybe you got a wife or a husband, if you love them, would you come and call their name and ask God to save them? Or if there's a situation you don't understand, maybe you're not what you ought to be with God, and you need to come and talk to him about it. If you've got a loved one that's lost, and you want to see them saved, I want you to stand on your feet right now, all over this building. Do you really love them? If you do, I want you to make your way to this altar. And I want you to call them. If you can't
kneel down, come and sit on the chair. Come and call their name right now. If you love them enough, come on. That little bit of effort could show the Lord I love them enough. In the name of Jesus, I love them enough. All of you that are standing, you want to be headed this way. You want to be headed this way. In the name of Jesus. Come on.
Preacher had to go check on Sister Abner. Let's all stand, if you would, we'd be dismissed. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for the message tonight, Lord. We thank you for every word, Lord, that was said. God, we know that your word will not return void unto thee. Father, I pray for Sister Abner, Lord, that you'll touch her, oh God. Pray for all the sick, Lord, and afflicted that's connected with the church. Lord, we know that you're the Almighty. We know, Lord, that your hand is not shortened, that you're not able to do these things. Now, Father, I pray, bless this congregation. Bless your people as we leave the house of God. Bring us back the appointed time, we ask in Christ's name. Amen.
What'd you do?